over the 17 years that I have been here. Tonight with us is Shahrooz. And Shahrooz is a magician, is an artist. Of course, that's an art, I believe, but we'll hear what is it exactly from Shahrooz himself. Shahrooz, good evening.
Good evening, thank
you. It is really interesting to have you here. I've been doing my shows for over 17 years now. I didn't have a chance to talk to a magician, to talk to an illusionist. And it is going to be, I think, a fun time we're going to spend together here tonight. So let's start with...
Well, thank you very much for the invitation, this matter. It's my first time being on Armenian TV. I'd like to say hello to all the viewers. And yes, you can ask me questions about the magic world of magic and what's around in Los Angeles, where they can go and see actually some live magic.
I like that phrase, the magic world of magic. So it's really interesting. And since you opened it up, let's start with, what is magic? When people do all these things, all these tricks, maybe should I call it, and make people disappear, try to cut people, and then people come back alive, one piece again.
Right.
Is that magic? It's that illusion? It's that technique? It's all of them? What is it? How does it work?
Okay, you got me to a point I cannot really tell you all the secrets, but you know what? I will have to tell you this, that it's the world of magic. It's world of illusions, you know, the timing. I mean, I cannot seriously, like all the magicians, tell you all the secrets, but it is about the art of illusion.
Uh-huh.
And the way it's done so beautifully perfected, and you know, some of these illusions and tricks, you can call them, come from the 1800s. And the base rules, it's like cleverly designed over, you know, a century ago. And it is the art of illusion, the art of misdirection. I should not tell you that. If a magician hears me, they would not like to hear that. But it is that art that is so different than any other, like music or singing or anything else. And you have to really master it to get the perfect timing.
Apparently. And then I wasn't wrong when I said Shahrooz is an artist. Now you're saying it's an art, and you said if magicians hear me now, they will get offended. It's the art of misdirection. Well, they don't have to be offended, because I think it's reasonably and logically conclusion. Absolutely. If I am looking at something and then I'm being kind of illusioned, that means that I have been misdirected.
Yes.
Probably my intention and my focus is somewhere, but you're doing something else somewhere else in a different way. So you're giving me that fun and that magic world of magic.
Yes.
Good to hear. Okay, so you mentioned also Los Angeles. If someone here wants to kind of master the art, and of course I understand it's going to be overnight. It takes years of learning and practice and mastering the art. Do we have the kind of facilities?
Yes, of course. There's a famous club, the Academy of the Magical Arts Incorporated, which is based in Hollywood, Magic Castle. I'm sure a lot of viewers know about this. It's a private club. Not everyone just can go in there. A member has to give a pass. A member has to become a magician member. They have to go through certain examination from the committee. And of course, we do have, I must say, magicians. I mean, the members who are not magicians, they can
say
they have interests, but they have to be introduced by a magician member.
Just to go and watch.
Yes, and then because they cannot just get in anytime they want. I do have actually some passes that I will sign them, and I'll send them to the station here at the your offices here, and people can call and we can give them out, you know. And by having that, they can go. There's a major dress code, you know. There's about 2-3 weeks of booking. You have dinner, you watch shows. It's the Victorian house back in 1920s that they built, and now 55th year anniversary was actually this year of this club. Mm. And it's very interesting. And there's a dress code, like I said, that you have to just, you will go and enjoy yourself. It's a very nice place. And then there are lectures you can learn.
Magic Castle.
The Magic Castle.
Yes. And it's here in Hollywood.
Everyone from the most famous magicians, from David Copperfield to, you know, all the famous magicians around the world are a member there. As a matter of fact, if you know the Johnny Carson, the famous Johnny Carson, used to be a magician before Johnny Carson. A lot of people may not know that, but Johnny Carson started as a magician.
You're mentioning some big names, basically, and Harry Houdini, right? David Copperfield, Johnny Carson. How did they make these buildings, huge buildings disappear and trains derail and buses fly.
They're so great that some other names are doing that. It's cleverly done. You know, as a matter of fact, I say this about our show that is happening on 22nd of December. We are doing a very, very huge grand illusion. We will make the whole cast, 10 people on stage, all the dancers, everyone will stand on this pyramid, triangular piece that has pyramids and triangles have a very special mysterious power to them, you know. And as they're standing there, right before your eyes, they disappear, right before your eyes, on stage, within a second. Don't blink an eye, you'll miss, and then they'll appear right in the front. So that's one of the things, I should have said that, but it's a very spectacular illusion that we've been building for the past few months.
We present that, we didn't hear it from them.
Yeah, but they need to hear that because it's a very strong scene that we're
building. We heard it, but we'll pretend we didn't. That's what I'm saying.
So it's, therefore, it's about your question was about how do they do that. It's just that beautiful puzzle, you know, that the timing of the misdirection that you figure out, look, it's not possible, but how is it possible? That's why people get amused at that second, at that moment they watch it, and then they go home to try to figure it out. And that figuring out, I think, is fun, just like you're trying to solve a puzzle. And I think that's entertainment. You know, we're not trying to trick people and say, oh, we are the smart ones, we're tricking you. It's just that that's the art of the entertainment of magic. That's what we have to do to entertain. And there's a lot of it these days on you know, all the major programs, America's Got Talent, you know, all the magic is a lot more popular these days, you know.
Good to hear. And at the same time, I agree with you. It's like the most fun way of solving a problem, thinking that how did that happen?
Yes.
How did they do it? And so on. Now, my additional question to this would be, you know, some people have some, naturally have some, what should I say?
Powers.
Yes, supernatural powers.
Hypnotism exists, of course.
Something like that. So is that also included here, having that supernatural things? You know, some people can kind of foresee something, I don't know,
yes.
That strong intuition.
Yeah, well, hypnotism exists, and we do have, again, when the girl floats in the air, some of that is used, it's just a combination of a little bit of everything. And
I see. What do you have to do now? Do you have to show us something now?
Well, I have a half a dollar here. You know, I've been doing this since I was a teenager. Don't ask me how old I am now, but...
No, I'm not asking you. I know that was only 10 years ago.
So it's a coin roll, we call it. It's a pretty fast coin roll. As you take it over here, come back here, and just comes back here. You want me to do a little wider shot so we can see this?
Well, that coin was just flipping, and it's just magic. That's a little big skill.
It goes over here, and just back to here.
Oh, now.
But I will show it, if you get up here, I will show it like this, my hand. I want to catch it here. I'm going to throw it up like this. One, two, three. I catch it over here, throw it up. There's nothing in my hand. Watch, and then back here. I thought we could catch it. Now, I'm going to do it a different way. I want you to watch and listen. When we talk about misdirection, there, of course, all this is done in such a smart way that when we place one over here, you can go close up on this. I'll start again. All right? I'm going to place one over here. Here comes the second one. You hear that. Two over there, one over here. All right? Two and one over here. I pick up the last one and just go. And one goes across, and one remains here. I hope they caught that. But you know what? What's more important, I think, I'm going to do this on your hand now. Now, this is a more challenging way of doing this.
Before doing anything, let's agree, you won't make me disappear, right?
No, unless you want to.
Or you won't make me two pieces. If you have a way of making like $1, $100, that's fine, but don't make me disappear.
Well, maybe we'll do that for you.
So what do you want me to do now?
Well, if we can have more close-up shots on this, we have basically a silver dollar here. You can check that. Can you go ahead and check it?
It is a silver dollar.
Okay.
Can you see it? It's in my hand now.
All right. And we have an old English penny. This is a very old English penny. It's real money, old English penny.
Yeah, it's a...
If we can go a little bit more close up so we can see...
The Elizabeth II Hey, gratis, yes. It's one penny.
Okay.
And it's 1967.
Wow. Yeah. So you told me all that, I didn't know about this one. Okay, you got these two other coins, quarter and a penny. I'll tell you why. If I could just have your hands, and we can have this a very close-up shot, if you can have that, so you can see. I'm going to place, so two silver, one penny, correct? I'm going to place one silver here. If you close your hand, you turn over.
Can I show them that it's in my hand?
Yes, but let me show you.
All right.
And then we're going to mark it with this silver. So you
okay.
Hold it tight, hold it tight.
It is tight.
And we have a penny and silver here, okay? I'm going to take the penny and the silver. I'm going to place the, close your hand, the pen here. And mark it with the penny, okay?
Mm-hmm. Nice.
So we don't need this one. Now. All right. Silver here, penny here, okay? I'm going to go like that. Did you see that go across? Your silver just went to your left hand. And the penny just went back to your right hand. You have the silver here, right?
Yes, I have. And
did you see that even there?
No, I'm not seeing it.
Okay, and this one went back here. Then you placed the position.
Mm-hmm.
You won't believe that, do you? I mean, you're not as crazy as I am, huh? Okay, can we have a close-up to see silver that was here now? You can turn your hand over. And it's gone to a penny. And this penny, if you open, turn your hand over, is the silver. They are the real silver penny. I didn't touch anything. You did the magic. Well done. You should join the club.
Okay, now.
We give you the membership.
I'm thinking seriously about that at this moment.
This is a very, very interesting one. It's today's world of magic is becoming more challenging, but it happens in the spectator's hand.
This was here.
Yeah.
And this was, sorry.
And that was
here.
That was there.
And we marked it, yes. And then I found them.
Seriously.
Well. I don't know what to say. Now I believe that you will make my $1, the single bills, making them 100.
Okay.
All right. So soon you're going to have a show. It's very soon. As you actually, you mentioned it, December 22nd. You mentioned a couple of things about just one thing, basically. What do you think? There will be something totally new for people?
Yes, this show.
Before yes. We go to the details,
uh-huh.
That's what the question that I was going to ask.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I meant. Because we're gonna go to a break and come back and we'll start with the show.
Okay.
You mind?
Sure.
All right.
No problem.
Right after the commercials, we'll be back and we'll see, I guess, more of things that are moving from one hand to
you do yourself.
My hand. And I don't know how, but I just all of a sudden became a magician.
Desde Venera Sumiki, Metropolitan. At the Warner Grand Theater, December 22nd. Delve into a new era of magic. An extraordinary style of magic. A portion of the show's proceeds will be donated to the City of Hope.
Shahrooz, I'm glad you are here in one piece. Because watching that, it's really interesting. There were these plates going at
yes.
Your neck level and your waist level, and then nobody was in. They opened the side and they shake hands.
Always from the back.
And then they opened the back and there was no tunnel in the back.
No.
And then you came out in one piece.
Well, that was a lucky one. I was almost not coming out in one piece, but it was lucky that night.
Oh, so you do these tricks only once, maybe, right?
No, they can't just do it again. You have to be sure.
Now, I trust you will make my single bills $100 after seeing this, but...
Oh, really?
I do. It looks like that I'm going to make a lot of money tonight here with you.
A lot of people like that trick.
All right. You already mentioned earlier the Academy of Magical Arts. So did you graduate from there? You attended there?
Yes, when I was a teenager, actually. And also I was a member of the Magic Circle, where I started in London. I was 16 years old, and I was performing live in some clubs. And then the Magic Castle. Yes, I've been a member for some years there. You have to perform your acts, whether close-up or any stage magic, in front of the committee, and the committee of the academy will honor and give the membership if you want to be a magician. Must pass the test.
So it's only a test, or you can learn there too?
To become a member, you need to do that. But also, they have lectures. You can go to the lectures and learn. And there is magic, basically. The art of magic has been 95%, has always been and still is. As a teenager, you have a major interest, and there is books. These days, with the social media, the YouTube, there's so much more to learn and more capability to learn everything. So you're
telling me that I cannot start now? I'm not a teenager.
No, you can start. You just did pretty well. For your first.
But seriously, that was really very interesting. It was in my hands, and I saw the silver going in, and then the penny going in here, and then.
And you did coming all in the time. I didn't touch anything. So that's today's world of magic. It's more challenging. A lot of magicians do that in the spectator's own hand. Mm-hmm. So you want to give me your dollar?
Oh, you want to make it? You want
to
make?
Unless you have 100, I can change it to a 1. It's more challenging.
No. I don't want that one. I don't. I do. Here's a dollar.
Oh, and by the way, I did wear very casual. I wanted to have no sleeves, as you can see, no sleeves, nothing in my hand. Okay.
Here's a dollar.
That's your dollar bill.
$1.
Got to know you today. We've never met. But anyway, it's a nice
thing. And I'm putting the rest in my pocket.
Okay, good. You only want one of them changed. Okay, there you go. Nothing in my hands. Please, again, nothing in my hands. This is your dollar. I fold it once. I fold it twice. The momentum goes fast. Nothing in my hands. You can keep it up close. All the way through. Fold it 3 times. Okay? Again, nothing in my hands. Please don't say you didn't say anything. There's still the one is over here. I will now fold it 4 times, right? And I will unfold. It will not leave your eyesight, okay? I will unfold, keep unfolding. And watch. Again, nothing in my hands. Please make sure it is a $100 bill.
Oh my God.
You can come up. Do you see that?
It's strengthening.
Totally.
Why did you put it there? That's mine.
I didn't put anything over
there. No, you put it there. It's mine.
Oh, this. Well, you know,
apparently we're going to have a dispute now. So let's go to the commercials until I get my $100 from. Okay.
That's $100 you can check. It's a real $100.
It's $100. And it's folded, actually, at that 4 times folding.
Can I just say something really quick, or we'll come back home? Something is a surprise for everyone. You can have your $100 bill, your dollar bill changed to $100 bill. We're going to throw the ball around 3 times in the audience. They will come on stage. We will take their dollar bill. We will change it to $100. They can walk away with it.
Here is one I got.
Are you going to go shopping? Christmas shopping today.
After the commercial break. I'm still enjoying my $100 bill. It's still here.
And surprised.
I'm trying to see if it is fake or real.
You haven't changed your wallet?
Yeah, I don't have that. And that they check it when you pay $100 bill in any market, but it's $100, Benjamin Franklin. And well, can we have a show every week?
Sure.
All right. I think we have another clip. Let's watch it, and
okay.
I guess we'll see a different realm there, and
yes.
We'll come back. Do you think this is all enough? Yet, could it happen? there. And Shahrooz, to be honest, the first clip we watched was captivating. The second one was totally different. It was amazing and beautiful. It was more that dance, but a dance that also brings a lot of aesthetics.
Yes.
Exactly. So apparently, I am assuming that the show, the upcoming show on the December 22nd, will kind of combine all of these.
Oh yes, and there's more. We have we travel the world with the music. Our dance numbers travel from French music, Italian, Spanish, matador, you know, partially Bollywood, modern Bollywood. So it's the show is about very different than other illusion shows out there. Storylines is a theme. And everything turns into magic. Magic comes unexpectedly, you know. The way we call it, stories turn to magic and magic turns to stories.
I think we got to talk about that in a little more detail when we come back for our next segment.
Sure.
Because it's not that people are just going there to watch a magician doing their tricks and illusions and so on. But earlier also there was a word about some discounted tickets, some promotions. Would you like to mention
that? For the viewers, they use the code Horizon TV. They would get 20% discount until the 18th.
December 18th.
Yes. And
so that will be online, the promo code Horizon.
Yes, if they go to shahroozmr.tix.com or call the number, they can use that and get 20% discount. However, I must say that the tickets are not that expensive, honestly. It's a big theater, but even the ones in the front are in the 50s, 60s, something like that. It's not that expensive. It's a very family-oriented show for all ages, and it's entertaining. I mean,
yeah, that was a very important point, and I was thinking of asking about that later, but you brought it up. Thank you. So there's no age limitations there. Everything that is going to be happening on the stage is family oriented.
Yes.
It's family appropriate.
Yes.
And that's very good to hear. And especially it's the Christmas time, you know.
Yes.
People go to these kind of places with a family. It's not only adults. So I really congratulate you on that part
Thank you.
And right after this last commercial, we'll come back and I guess we'll talk a little bit more detail about the show. I don't know, I might get another $100.
Maybe change it for 10,000.
After the commercial, we'll be back. 2 minutes only. Yes, I'm happy. Got $100, apparently. And back, Shahrooz is with us, and there is. I like the idea, Shahrooz. I like the idea of having a theme, as you mentioned, or even a storyline.
Yes.
Usually, these kind of shows are made as magic shows during some, not necessarily always just stage shows, but even if they are stage shows, they are part of something else. However, what I'm understanding here in this case that we do have a full show that includes magic, not as one number, but it goes into the story. That is the idea that I like the most.
Right.
And if you don't mind, could you please tell us about that a little better? As you said, magic comes at a point.
Yes.
Not for the purpose of doing magic, but serving the purpose of the story itself.
Right.
Did I get it right?
Yes, exactly. Yes. You know, I've been doing magic for years and years, and which is great, you know. You see quick magic, they bring the props, the girl goes in,
they make $100.
Everything is like very fast. And the idea, that's why Shahrooz Mister is French, it comes from, I was always inspired by the French magicians, French theatrical situation where they have always a storyline, there's always a theme. So I was inspired by that for years and years. So finally, I put together the acts that I have. There's an act, again, every act has its own theme and story, which is sometimes hard to understand. You know, when you watch a movie, it's kind of hard to understand what the story was so much for a live theater. But it's, the choreography is done such a way that there's a theme, that every number has its own costume, there's a love story, there's a, every act has a story, and the story turns into magic unexpectedly. At least for most of the show. And then there is, we have the aerialist, we have, of course, the master of the ceremony, a great magician, very regular at the Magic Castle. He's won some awards. He's the MC and the comedy magic of the show. And then we have, you know, a lot of dance numbers, and we'll do some something with the audience. I will actually turn your dollar bill. Please come and witness this for yourself. We will throw the ball in three area, different areas. The third person that catches it, so, you know, it's at random. We don't know anyone. They come on stage, we'll do the same thing, and they can walk away with that $100 bills. Merry Christmas. So that's, it's just something that no magicians has actually ever done that. And so there, it's a theme. It's a mixture of everything. It's not just magic. And there are a lot of shows out there that big names that travel, you know, all over the world. But there are five magicians. They're doing comedy. They're doing all kinds of different kinds of magic. But it's only magic. And I wanted to offer more and make it more of a variety show, like a Vegas type of a Lido. French video type of a show that is more entertaining. You know, magic's great, but I think people get a little bit aggravated. They want to be tricked so many times. There's got to be some other entertainment. And maybe some a few big illusions that we create for this show. So that's basically what it is. And
then apparently people will not be there to watch magic, as we call it. But illusionist tricks and art, it's a very high art, let me admit, of course.
Thank you.
But they will be kind of watching the play.
Yes, actually, exactly. It's like I would say something like a Broadway play. It's like, you know, we don't know. I'm not the judge of that. The audience has to be the judge of that. It's a well-mixed a play that it has magic properties and aerial dance, comedy.
And that is going to be one more time, December 22nd, which is a Saturday, I believe. It's a Saturday. Warner Grand Theater, it's on the screen now, which is actually in San Pedro.
Yes.
I think it's 478 West 6th Street.
Yes. Actually, I must say something about that. The first Warner Brothers Theater, one of the three that built back in 1920s, was in San Pedro. This is the actual theater. Inside is beautiful. I should have brought a video of that. Very beautiful architect from 1920s. And their 70th, and later on, a few years later on, they turned that movie theater to a theater, play theater. And it's their 70th birthday on Sunday 23rd. That's really amazing. They have a
70th.
Film festival in that place. 70th birthday of that theater.
So apparently this is a Warner Bros. Theater.
Yes.
It wasn't named after them, but it was actually Warner Brothers
movie theater. And then since
that 1920s. That itself is very interesting to me.
Yes, that's why I chose this place. It's very, cultural, that's the right word I'm using, but it's very beautiful inside. Seriously, the architecture is amazing.
And I believe and I agree that when you go to that kind of a performance, it's also another fun to be in a place that has its own smell, legacy, and
yes,
its own atmosphere,
yes,
and everything all together. It kind of blends in that big picture,
exactly,
of big structure that is going to be called Shahrooz Mister, Saturday, December 22nd, 8 p.m.
Yes.
8 p.m. And it's the Warner Grand Theater, 478 West 6th Street, San Pedro, of course, California. So, 8 o'clock, December 22nd.
Magic Creations presents Shahrooz Mister at the Warner Grand Theater, December 22nd. Into a new era of magic. An extraordinary style of magic. A portion of the show's proceeds will be donated to the City of Hope. Call 1-800-595-4849.
I'm really actually fascinated and at the same time happy. I guess if you were watching the show now, you'll know why I'm happy. I'm still here, the $100 is still here. I'm trying to convince Shahrooz to make it another $100. I guess he's going to, there will be several people during that show who would walk after the show with $100 in their pockets, starting with $1 only. Here I am, the live proof. So December 22nd, people are going to be enjoying actually a play that has all parts of theatrical and stage arts combined in one place, including music and dance and aerialist dance.
Comedy,
yeah, exactly. And magic that just comes to serve the big purpose. I like that big idea. So one more time before we say thank you, and before we say thank you also to our viewers, what are the points that you wanted to you would want to talk about, and I didn't maybe ask about it? I don't know. Do you want to go over the discounts or any kind of promotion there?
Well, there's also apart from that, we are goldstar.com is a partnership with Groupon, and there are some lower price tickets. I should mention $20, $30, $40 tickets that are they cannot assign their seat number, but they are not depending on the price, are not too far back. But those are great, fantastic prices if they want to go goldstar.com, and
And for the basic one, which one was
the 20% that you have till 18th if you go.
That's for Horizon, for our viewers.
Yes, you can use that code and you can assign your seat. And
and that would be on
shahrooz.tix.com. Or they can go to shahrooz.tix.com and go to our website. From there, they can see they will,
they
can be connected, yes. Mm-hmm. I really would like people, your audience, to know that it's a different show, and it's,
I could tell.
Seriously, it's a family show. I know a lot of people are busy, have plans, but it's a 1.5 hour show. We never mentioned, but a little over 1.5 hours actually. That's a few people that have talked to me who never met before came to me and said this was very. It went too fast for me. It was just. So much variation.
That's the fun.
Right. And that was, I was happy to hear that. So, and it's not too far. You know, honestly, San Pedro is only, if you do a drive from here to downtown, anywhere from LA to downtown, or, anywhere, there's from there to Burbank, from LA area, it's about the same drive.
Yes, from downtown. All right. So, apparently, we did have a different type of a fun today. And I would really thank you very much, Shahrooz, to be here.
Thank you for having me.
It's my pleasure. And we wish you all the best. And wish our audience to have the greatest fun on the December 22nd. And I got my fun part. And I guess I get another $100 on that day. I'm just so happy to be here. Thank you very much,
Charles.
Thank you.